Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and I wanted to show you how to back up and restore from your old iPhone or current iPhone to a new iPhone 13, iPhone 13 mini, iPhone 13 Pro, or iPhone 13 Pro Max. I'm going to walk you step by step how to do this, and there's a few things you'll need to know before we get started. And the first thing is, you'll need your Apple ID and password to complete the transfer for security reasons. You'll also need additional passwords for things like WhatsApp and Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and some additional things that want more security or just require those passwords for additional security. So you'll want to have those ready as they may make you log back in. Now, before we get started and transfer everything, if you're on the home screen on your new phone, you'll need to reset your phone to get back to the startup screen you're seeing here. This phone is currently on iOS 15 as iPhone 13 comes pre-installed with it. And so you'll need to make sure that you're on the setup screen before we get started. If you're not, you'll need to reset the new phone. And you can do that by going to your settings. Under settings, go to general. Under general, go down to transfer or reset phone. And under transfer and reset iPhone, it says erase all contents and settings. Once you erase all contents and settings, it will wipe the phone. It will not affect the old phone. So if you're wiping the new phone to get back to the setup screen, it will not be affected, but you will need to do this in order to start the transfer process. So we'll hit not now. Now, as far as everything that transfers from your old phone to your new phone, it will bring everything from text messages, WhatsApp messages, apps, app data, music, photos, and even email accounts. However, some of those may make you log back in, but typically they'll just set up on their own depending on what type of authentication you're using. So there's three different backup methods or restore methods. You can use an iTunes backup on Windows or a Mac. You can also use iCloud, and this is a newer method that they've given you extra storage for this year, and we can wirelessly transfer. I'm going to show you how to wirelessly transfer since it's the easiest way. But if you want to use an iCloud backup, just to be safe, you can go to your settings, and this year, even if you don't have enough storage, as long as you're on iOS 15, you can go down and go to general under your settings, go down to transfer or reset iPhone and tap on get started. Under get started, it says you'll be ready for your new iPhone. That's it for now. Your iPhone is using iCloud to secure all your data. It's uploading apps and data to iCloud. Use this iPhone to quickly sign in, and then you can trade in your old phone if you want to. It will loan you the data on iCloud for about a month or a few weeks until you can transfer from your old phone to your new phone. So even if you're not paying for a lot of iCloud storage, you can do that. But there's an even easier way to do this. Now, what we'll need to do is bring the phone close. And many of you may be wondering already, when do I transfer my SIM card? And you can transfer your SIM card at any time. As long as you have a Wi-Fi connection, you can use it without the SIM card, or you can just transfer it right away. You can transfer it before or after. It doesn't really matter. So we'll turn on the new phone and we'll swipe up. And once we do that, bringing the phone nearby automatically pops up and says, set up a new iPhone. So once that's on your screen, you can do that and just tap continue. Now, if you're not seeing it, turn off your display and then move it away and bring it back. So if you're not seeing this pop up, move it away, turn off your display, unlock your phone and bring it back. But we'll unlock it, we'll scan it here, and it will say finish on new iPhone. So the screen's really bright here because I can't turn it down. Now it goes down once it's scanned. So now we'll put in the passcode of the current phone that we're using. So it's the same password you log into your phone with if you reboot it. And then it will say setting up your iPhone. So we'll give it just a moment to start setting up. And at the same time, it will say finish on your new phone. And then on the new phone, it says it may take a few minutes to activate your iPhone. So just give it a few minutes and it will activate. It automatically carries over your Wi-Fi settings that you might have, and it's pretty simple to set up overall. So now we're at the point where we need to set up Face ID. Since all of the new phones have Face ID, we'll hit continue. And then we'll hit get started. So just put your face in the frame here, and then you just move your head around like this. And then you'll do it one more time. So you'll hit continue. There's also accessibility options here if you need them. You just have to fill in the rings and then hit continue. Now the next part is, after we hit continue, we'll wait for this just a moment. And it says transfer data from iPhone 11. So we have continue or other options. It says, if you're moving from an iPhone 11, you can transfer all of its data and settings directly to this iPhone. Keep your other iPhone nearby and connected to power until the transfer is completed. So you want to make sure you have enough battery on the other phone and connect to power if needed. And it says estimated time of transfer, 45 to 55 minutes. This will vary depending on how much data you have on the old phone compared to this phone. The estimated time to transfer will vary depending on how much data you have on your old phone. It could be shorter or longer, but now we'll go ahead and hit continue. Now it says setting up your Apple ID. Now in the previous page, if we would have hit the other options, that's where we would set up our iCloud or other data if we want to transfer that way. Otherwise, it's just easier to do it this way, and then we'll agree to the terms of service. We'll wait for it to complete here. After it's done setting up your Apple ID, you'll see that it says, make this your new iPhone. It says, here's everything set up as you had it on your other phone. So it shows apps and data transfer directly from iPhone. Then it has settings, and these are all of your different settings. You can customize these now or leave everything as it was already set up on the previous phone. So if you're happy with that, go ahead and hit continue. Now it says, keep your iPhone up to date. And it's just telling you to leave it on automatic updates. You can change this at a later date or later date and go ahead and hit continue. Now, if you had Apple cards previously set up, here's where you can move them over to this phone. You can set them up later or hit continue. So I'll set them up later. Now at this point, it says transferring data from iPhone 11. Keep your other iPhone nearby and connected to power until the transfer is complete. And it's giving us an estimated time. This will change. Initially, it started at 11 minutes. Now it says 26. So usually it takes less than this. And what it's doing is connecting directly to the phone. So it's transferring directly to the phone. Just set them nearby and leave them alone. And it should transfer everything over. So we'll come back when this is complete. And you'll see it's 5:03 PM right now. You can see on the iPhone 11, it says transfer complete. Your data has been transferred to your other iPhone. And so at this point, we wait for the other iPhone to reboot, and then we'll be back on the home screen. So we'll hit continue on the old phone. And now it's asking us if we want to erase this phone. So we can do this later on. But one thing to note is you do not want to erase photos individually. You want to erase the whole phone as a whole, because that way it won't affect the older phone. So just keep that in mind. Erase the phone either through here or hit not now. And then you can do it again later by going to settings and then go down to general, and then go down to transfer or reset iPhone. And then you can reset your phone or erase it. So you can give it away or trade it in or sell it to someone else. So just keep that in mind. Now, also at the top here, it's asking you what you want to do for the next step. It says get step-by-step instructions to prepare this iPhone to be sold, given away, or traded in through Apple Trade-In. So you can say don't erase, but it's helping you step-by-step through this process. Like I said, do not delete the photos individually, as they will sync across devices and delete. But if you delete the whole phone together by itself, it will delete everything off the phone and not affect the new phone. Now you can see the new phone booted up, and this whole process took about 27 to 28 minutes. Now it's asking me if you want to use this iPhone when sharing your location. And as long as you want to switch to this phone right away, hit use. If not, hit not now. Now at this point, the phones are completely synced. So everything is the same. And now it will begin restoring all the apps that you have, as you can see here. So the home page arrangement is the same as I go from page to page, and everything is identical. And your app library auto sorts. So that may look a little bit different here, but everything else will be the same with all of your restored data and more. So you'll see the library layout and everything. Your messages will be there, and the devices will be synced at this point, where if you text on one device, you'll actually see it on the other if you have iCloud messages turned on or messages in iCloud. So they're completely synced. When you wipe your old device, it will not affect the new device. So just keep that in mind. Now, not only did it bring over everything as far as the apps, it also connected things such as your AirPods. So these will be available on your iPhone as well. They'll just show up and be there automatically. So it just moves everything and makes everything very simple to transfer. Now, one additional thing to mention is if you're an iOS beta tester or developer, and you're on, say, iOS 15.1 or any future version of iOS, you will need to either have a backup prior to that or set up the new phone as new, or go to the home screen, install the beta on the new phone, then reset the new phone, and then you can restore everything. You cannot restore from a future version to an older version of iOS. So just keep that in mind. And so that's everything with transferring from an old phone to a new phone. Hopefully that was helpful. And I'd love to hear from you which phone you moved from and to. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.